programming. This is a KCSE syllabus form 4, and by the end of this topic you should be able to form linear inequalities, to solve linear inequalities, number 3, solve linear inequalities by graphing, that is drawing the graph, and number 4, optimization of given linear inequalities, and this is where you you get the maximum or the minimum of any given situation. So you are welcome. This is the first lesson, and in this lesson we are going to cover forming linear inequalities. In your earlier course, that is linear inequalities form 2, you can check on this topic. If you have not gone through it, you learned solutions of simple linear inequalities. In this lesson we are going to learn inequalities representing given conditions involving real life situation. We are going to do this using examples. So let's have a look at our example one. In our first example, George is 6 years younger than his brother. The sum of their ages is less than 48. If George's age is X years, form all the inequalities in X for the situation. So first of all, we start with the age of X. Age of X must be greater than 0 because the age cannot be negative. 2, we are given the sum of their ages is, we start with George, age 6 years younger than his brother. So it means if George is X, the brother is X plus 6. The second statement, we are told the sum of their ages is less than 48. So it means the age of George plus the age of his brother, that is X plus 6, is less than 48. We put the right terms together and we sign 2x plus 6 is less than 48. Take 6 to the other side, you have 2x is less than, it becomes minus. So 48 minus 6 becomes 42. We divide by 2, both sides, divide by 2, and this will simplify. This is 1, 2 divided by 2 is 1. 42 divided by 2 becomes 21, implying that X is less than 21. So that is how you get the inequality. So the inequalities that we have is X is less than 21, but X is greater than 0. So these two are correct. So that's how you work it out. In our example 2, we are told the perimeter of a rectangle whose length is x centimeter and the width y centimeter is not more than 20 centimeter. Find all the inequalities connecting x and y. So we start with the perimeter of a rectangle. Since we have been given the length and the width, then it is 2 into bracket x plus y, which gives you 2x plus 2y. Now, since we are told that the perimeter is not more than 20, okay, let's use this one. We can say 2x plus y is less than or equals to 20. Not more than 20 means that the perimeter can be 20. So we can divide both sides by 2, divide by 2. Then our x plus y is less than or equals to 10. That is one inequality. The others, since x and y are dimensions, then we can say dimensions cannot be more than less than 0, so it means that x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0. So these are the inequalities that we can get from the given situation. Example 3, we are told the sum of two integers a and b is less than 5 times their difference. Their product is not less than 18. If a is greater than b, form all the inequalities representing the situation. So we are told that the sum of a and b, so we say a plus b is less than five times the difference. So we say a minus b. So that is the first inequality. So we can simplify this and say this is a plus b is less than 5a minus 5b. So we take b to this side, so we say 5b plus b, we take a to the other side, is less than 5a minus a. So we can say 6b is less than 4a. So we can simply say that b is less than 4 over 6a, which is b is less than 2 over 3a. Therefore, we go back to the question. Their product is not less than 18. So this means that we can say AB is greater than 18, or greater than or equals to, because not less than, it could be 18. If A is greater than B, so we are told that A is greater than B. So those are the inequalities that we form, and that's how you go about it. In our example 4, Monkey has 10 more goats than Wangoi. Altogether, they own not less than 60 goats, with Wangoi's goat numbering more than a third of the total. By choosing a letter to represent the number of Wangoi's goats, write down all the inequalities representing the situation. So we can say let X represent Wangoi's goats, so going back to the question, Mwangi has 10 more goats than Wangoi, so we can say Wangoi owns 10 X, and Mwangi then owns X plus 10. Altogether, they own not less than 60 goats. So it means if you add X plus X plus 10, that will give you total is greater than or equals to 60, which we can simplify, add 2X, take 10 to the other side, this is 60. It becomes greater or equals to 10, becomes negative, so we have 60 divided by 10, we get 50. Divide both sides by 2, you get X is greater or equals to 25. So that is one inequality that we have. The other one, we are told Wangoi's goat numbering more than a third of the total, so it means that we can write X is greater than a third of the total. The total is 2X plus 10. Multiply both sides by 3, you get 3X is greater than 2X plus 10. So take 2X to this other side, it becomes negative. So 3x minus 2x, you get x is greater than 10. So that's another inequality. So these are the inequalities that exist from the given situation. So that brings us to the end of this topic or lesson, and we have achieved our goal of forming inequalities from given situation. So I hope you have understood that, and let's now move to lesson 2. Welcome to the second lesson in linear programming, and in this lesson we are going to deal with solutions of linear inequalities, and we can say that the linear inequalities are solved by first manipulating each of the given situation separately and then combining them, and you have solved similar questions in the earlier course. That is linear inequalities in Form 2. So if we are going to do this using a few examples, but you can still go to Form 2 and check what we did. Check the topic linear inequalities. In our example 1, we are told Mary is twice as old as her sister Jane, who is not less than 5 years old. The sum of their ages is not more than 30. Given that Jane is X years old, form all the inequalities in X to represent the above information, and hence find the range of their values of X satisfying this inequality. So Mary is, so if we are told that, if we take Jane, is X years old, then we say that Mary is twice as old as her sister. So it means Mary is 2X years. The sum of their ages is not more than 30. This means that X plus 2X is not more than 30, so less than or equals to 30, which we can say 3x is less than or equals to 30. Divide both sides by 3, divide by 3, then we should be able to get, this is 3 divided by 3 is 1, this is 30 divided by 3 is 10, so you get x is less than or equals to 10. Then we are told that Jane is not less than 5 years. This means that our X is not less than 3 years. So is less than, we can say is less than, is not less than, but is greater than or equals to 5. So with that, we can now combine and say X is greater than or equals to 5 and less than or equals to 10. So that is how we combine the two situations, the two inequalities, and we come up with the range of their ages. So this implies that since we are given the X is the age of Jane, the age of Jane is between 5 or and 10, could be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10. So that's how you combine that. Our example 2, we are told the length of a room is 4 meters more than its width. The width is greater than 5 meters, while the perimeter of the room is not greater than 36 meters. Given that the width of the room is b meters, find the range of values of b satisfying all the inequalities representing the situation. So we are given width is equals to b meters. And since we have been given length is 4 meters long, then we can say length is equals to b plus 4 meters. So that is what information given. So we are told width is greater than 5 meters. So it means that b is greater than 5, and then we are told the perimeter of the room is greater than 36. The perimeter of the room, we get perimeter is equals to 2, the width which is b plus b plus 4. So this is equals to 2b plus 4, which is equals to 4b plus 8. This means that since the perimeter is not greater than 36, then we say that 4b plus 8 is less than or equals 36. We simplify, take 8 to the other side, becomes minus, so 36 minus 8 is 28. So we have 28 is less than, that is b is less than, that is not 28, but 4b is less than or equals 28, b is less than or equals to 7. And since we already have here b is greater than 5, and here we have b is less than 5, we start by writing b is less than or equals to 7 and greater than 5. So that is how you combine this information to come up with a single representation of the inequality. So this is our lesson 3 in linear programming, and in this lesson we are going to learn solution by graphing. In our lesson 2, we represented our inequalities in a combined form, just a statement. But in this lesson, we are going to learn how this solution can be represented on a graph. So solutions to inequalities formed to represent given condition can be represented by graphing the inequalities and then reading off the appropriate values. So this means that in this section we'll be dealing with the inequalities in a graph, where they will represent a certain region, like the one I have here, and then we can be able to see the solutions that are represented in this region, or the kind of various options that can be represented in the given inequalities. So let's do that using an example. So in our example one, we are told a student wishes to purchase not less than 10 items comprising books and pens only. A book costs 20 shillings and a pen costs 10 shillings. If the student has 220 shillings to spend, form all the possible inequalities from the given condition and graph them, indicating the solution. So we can be able to do this. Let's say books are represented by X, and pens to be represented by X. So since he needs to buy not less than 10 items, then it means that not less than 10, then it means that X plus number of books plus number of pens must be greater than or equals to 10. So that is our first inequality that we are going to graph. The other one, we are told that each book costs 20 shillings and the pen costs 10 shillings. So we can say if we bought X books, so you multiply 20 multiplied by X plus, then we have 10 multiplied by Y should be less than or equals to 220, because that is the money that he had, the student had, and cannot spend more than what he had with him or her. So we can simplify this by dividing by 10, divide by 10, divide by 10. Here you say this is 10 divided by 10, that gives you that, that gives you that. Then you have our inequality is 2x plus y is less than or equals to 22. So this is our second inequality. Then the other inequalities, we have, of course, he had to buy a pen, so x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0. So these are the inequalities that exist in this situation. So we have to get the graph of this. So we first of all take x plus y is equals to, we say it is 10. That's a linear equation. We need a minimum of a maximum of 3 points. So we have x and y, and we say when x is 0, y is 10. Then when x is 5, y is 5, and when x is 10, y is 0. So we are substituting here. Then our next inequality is 2x plus y is less than or equals 22. So we write the equation representing that plus y is equals to 22. We make at least, we need at least a maximum of 3 points. So we have x and y. So we say when x is 0, y is 22. When x is 5, y is, this is 22, not 20. When x is y, this is 12. When x is 11, y is 0. So with this, we are going to use a graph to plot this and identify the region represented by these inequalities. That is that one, this one, this one, and this one. So let's go ahead and plot that. So this is a graph that I'm going to use. I have already inserted my inequalities and the equations for convenience, so that I'll be able to read from here. When you are doing an exam, of course, you are working on the same page. So we start by making our Cartesian plane. So we say this is our, we can start here, this is our starting point. So this is 2, that is 4, 6, 8, and this is 10, 12, and that is 14. That is our x-axis. And this is our y, we say it's 5, this is 10, this is 15, this is 20, 25, and this is our y-axis. As I always say, always remember to label your axis, and always use a pencil when you are plotting or when you are drawing. So we start by plotting this. So we say when we use this point, when x is 0, y is 10. So that is where we have our point. When x is 5, y is 5. So that's where we have our second point. When x is 10, y is 10. So we are going to join the 3 points to come up with a straight line. And we are going to plot a straight line, a complete line rather, because of our symbol here, it is greater than or equals to, meaning 10 is part of the inequality. This is our graph, which is y is, that is x plus y is equals to 10. Then we check the side that satisfies our inequality. We can take the point we can take the point 0, 0, that is on this side. We check 0 plus 0, is it greater than 10? No, 0 is not greater than 10. So we check with the other side, we can take a point like 10, that is 10, 10. We say 10 plus 10 is 20. Is 20 greater than 10? Yes. So it means that this side, the upper side, satisfies our inequality. So we shade off this other side. So that is the side that does not satisfy our inequality. Then from there, the other equation is 2x plus y is equals 22. So when x is 0, y is 22. So this is where we have 22 is there. When x is 5, y is 12. So 12 is there. When x is 11, y is 0. So that is where we have our point. So we join the 3 points to come up with the graph represented by that. So this is a graph of 2x plus y is equals to 22. It is a complete line because our symbol is less than or equals to, meaning 22 is part of the inequality or the condition. Then we now check the side that does not satisfy our condition. We still use, let's still use 0, 0. This is a point on the lower side. And you say that this will be 0 plus 0 is less than 22. So this side satisfies our inequality. We use 10 and 10. This will give us 2 times 10 is 20 plus 10 is 30. Is that less than 22? No. So it means that this side does not satisfy our inequality. So we shade off that side, that is a side that does not satisfy our inequality. What remains now is x is equals to, x is 0 and y is 0. So we use x is equals to 0 and y is equals to 0. We plot the two lines to come up with that is x is equals to 0 and y is equals to 0 to come up with the sides that do not satisfy. Because he had to buy at least a book and a pen, it means that this is equals to or greater or equals to 0. So let's plot that. So these are the graphs of x is equals to 0, y is equals to 0. So we just shade off x is less than, greater than 0. This side is the one that does not satisfy our condition. And also this side of x, so that is where we shade off. So now we have completed plotting the our inequalities, and now we can interpret our region. This is the region that we are looking for, the region represented by this inequality. What this means that he can buy one book and that is one pen and 10 books. That's one condition. So x is 2 and y is this is our x, this is our y, and that is x is 1. So we have our x and y. So x can be 1, this is 10, on and on, could be 1 and 15, could be, we can take 2 and 10, 2 and 10, we can take 4 and 10, we can take 9 and 9 and 3, 9 and 3. So all these are options, all these points. So we have so many options there. So that is how you represent your inequalities on a graph. I hope you have followed. Let's do another example and see whether we'll be able to get to understand this better. In this example, we are told a car firm hires X Toyotas and Y Subarus cars in a day. At most, 8 cars are hired per day for a total charge of more than 18,000. The higher charge per day is 2,000 shillings and 3,000 shillings for a Toyota and Subaru car respectively. For more, the possible inequalities for this situation and graph them. From the graph, list the possible solutions. So here we say, since we are already given X represent Toyota and Y represent Subaru, at most 8 cars are to be hired. So it means that we can say X plus Y is less than or equals to 8. That is, the number of cars must not go beyond 8, as we are given there. Then we are told that for a Subaru, it is for a Toyota, it is charged 2,000, and for a Subaru, it is 3,000. So the total charge is more than 18,000. This means that if you multiply 2,000 times the number of Toyotas to be hired, 3,000 plus 3,000 of the number of Subarus to be hired must be more than 18,000, which we can simplify by dividing by 1,000. Here we cancel 3, so we have this is equals to 2x plus 3y is greater than 18. Then we have, since they have to hire Toyotas and Subaru, this means that X is greater than or equals to 0, and Y is greater or equals to 0. So that is, those are the inequalities that we need to draw. We need to make tables for this. So we start by, this will give us, the first one will give us Y plus X is equals to 8. So we make, get 3 points. So this is our X, that is our Y. When X is 0, Y is 8. When X is 4, Y is 4. When X is 8, X is 0. Then the other one is 2X plus 3y is equals to 18. So we make a minimum of 3 points. So we have, this is X and that is our Y. When X is 0, Y is 6, that is, you substitute here. When X is 3, this will be 6, will give us 12. 12 divided by 3 is 4. So when X is 9, Y is 0. So with this point, we are going to use a graph to plot them and come up with a list of possible solutions. So let's go ahead and do that. The graph that I'm going to use, I have already inserted my inequalities and the equation for convenience. And this is a graph paper that I'm going to use. So let me first of all label my axis. So let me start there. And I say this is the starting point. So we can have our X is, we can say 1, or we can say, let's start with 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. This is our X axis. Our Y axis, this is a 2, this is 4, that's our 6, this is 8, and this is 10, that is our Y axis. So I'm going now to plot the graph of X plus Y is equals to 8. So when X is 0, Y is 8, that's where we have our point. When X is 4, Y is 4, we have the second point. When X is 8, Y is 0. So we join the 3 points to come up with a straight line, which should be a complete line. So this is our graph of x plus y is equals to 8. We take the side that satisfy our inequality. We take a point like 0, 0. So we substitute 0 plus 0 is less than 8. That's correct. So we check with another point like 10, 10. 10 and 10. So 10 plus 10 is 20. It's not less than 0. So this means that this side does not satisfy our inequality. So we shade off. So that is the side that does not satisfy our inequality. From there, we now move to the other one, which is 2x plus 3y is equals to 18. When x is 0, y is 6. So when x is 3, y is 4. And when x is 9, y is 0. So this is where we have our point. We join the three points to come up with the graph, which should be should not be a complete line, a dotted line. So this is a graph of can say is a graph of 2x plus 3y is equals to 18. We check the side that satisfy our inequality. Then we can say when we use the same two points here, 0, 0, 2 times 0 is 0, 3 times 0 is 0. So 0 is not greater than 18. So that side, we check with the other side, we take 10, 10. So this is 20 plus 30 is greater than 18. So this is the side that we are going to shade off. It does not satisfy our inequality. And of course, now we have y is greater than. So here we need to change the line. It should be dotted line. Dotted means that 18 is not part of the inequality. So that is when you plot a dotted line. And then we plot the graph of already x is out, x is greater, it's not part of the region. So we draw the graph of y greater than or equals to 0. So that is the line of y is greater or y is equals to 0. And this is the side that does not satisfy our inequality. Y is greater than 0. So we say that we shade off the part that is not satisfying the equation. So this is the region that is satisfied by the inequalities that we have. So from there, we look at the possibilities that are represented by this region. Since x is already out of the region, we plot the graph of y is equals to 0. So let's draw that. So that is a graph of y is equals to 0, and we just shade off the side that does not satisfy our inequality. So that is the side. So this is the region that we have, and now what remains is to interpret our region. So you can say that these are the options that exist. For example, it can take 0 Toyotas here and 6 Subarus, or 6 is not part of that, so we can say or 7, can say 8, or 7. It can also take 2 Subarus and 5, 2 Subarus, that is this point. 2 Subarus and 5, that is 2 Toyotas and 5 Subarus, that's another option. He can also take 2 Subarus and 6 Toyotas, that is 2 Toyotas and 6 Subarus. The options are so many. As you can read, these values that are part of, you can also take 1 Toyota and 7 Subarus. all the parts, all the values that you can read from this region, apart from the values that rise on the line, the green line, the green dotted line, because those values are not inclusive of the inequality or the, that particular situation. So that is how you work out that. I hope you have followed. You have also covered this in linear inequalities in Form 2. I don't think drawing the linear graphs is that difficult. So that's the end of this lesson. We will now move to our lesson 4, which is optimization. Welcome to our lesson 4 in linear programming, and in this lesson we are going to look at linear programming, or what we call optimization. So linear programming is an optimization technique aimed at finding the values of variables that maximize or minimize the objective function. Optimize means the action of making the best of most effective use of a situation or a resource. So in this lesson, in lesson 3, we considered inequalities with several possibilities. In this lesson, we'll deal with identification of possible solutions that will give us possible maximum or minimum. So this is whereby in lesson 3, we dealt with the various options, but in optimization, we look at the option that will give you the maximum or the minimum. This means that, for example, if you are transporting students, a teacher is transporting student, he has to, and is given a certain budget, he has to decide either to use, and is using maybe minibus and the small van, the Nissan, then he has to decide how many minibus to use and how many small van to use, so that the budget can fit. The more the teacher is able to utilize the two types of vehicles, he will be able maybe to save a little from the money available and be able to transport maximum student. In business, if you are selling something, two types of maybe maize flour, you mix the two and you want to make the maximum profit, you must know the ratio and how, where you are going to make a maximum profit. So that is what you'll be dealing with in this section. It is one of the sections that confuses many students, and I hope today, after going through it, you will be able to understand it. Here we are going to use a technique of a ruler and a set square to be able to determine the minimum and the maximum. So let's do an example and see how it works. In our example 1, we are told a farmer needed to transport 1,000 bags of maize to the Cereals Board of Kenya using a lorry and a pickup. The lorry can carry a maximum of 80 bags, while the pickup can carry a maximum of 20 bags. The pickup is to make more than twice the number of trips the lorry makes, and the total number of trips has to be less than 30. The cost per trip is 2,000 for Kenyan shillings for the lorry and 900 Kenyan shillings for the pickup. Find the minimum expenditure. So for us to do this, we need to form the inequalities necessary. So we can start with let the number of trips made by the lorry be x, and pickup be y. So we can say the number of trips, we are told the number of trips to be made are less than 30. So we can say x plus y is less than 30, the number of trips. Then again, we are told that the lorry carries 80 bags and the pickup carries a maximum of 20 bags. This means that if we multiply the number of bags carried by the lorry plus the number of bags carried by the pickup, should be less than or equals to, or that is, should be greater or equals to 1,000. If we simplify this by dividing by 20, divide by 20, divide by 20, we will get that 4xy plus y is greater or equals to 50. So that is what we get when we simplify. That is from you need to transport 1,000 bags. So the number of bags should not be less than 1,000. Should be more or 1,000. The other inequalities are the pickup is to make twice the number of trips the lorry makes. So if we take y, the number of trips made by the pickup should be greater than 2x, the number of trips made by the lorry, and therefore and then we have x is greater than zero. So with these inequalities, we need to find the minimum. By minimum we mean the minimum expenditure the farmer will incur by using the pickup and the lorry. So our aim here is to get how many trips should the lorry make and how many trips the pickup makes to make the minimum cost of transport. We are told that the lorry charges 2,000 shillings, the pickup charges 900. So that is what we mean by optimization. This is the grid that I'm going to use, and I've already inserted our inequalities that we have come up with. So with this one, we can get the equation is x plus y is equals to 30. We get the points when x is y, x and y. So when x is, we can say when x is 10, we substitute y is 20. When x is 20, y is 10. Then with this one, we say that's 4x plus y is equals to 50. We make our table. In this case, I just want to use 2 points so that it doesn't take a lot of time. So we have our x and we have our y. When x is 0, y is 50. And when x is 10, y is 10. With this one, we say y is equals to 2x. We make a table. We say that is x and this is our y. So when x is 0, y is 0. When x is 20, this will be 20 times 2, y will be 40. And then this will be the graph of y is equals to x is equals to 0. So with this, then we can be able to plot the graphs. So I'll start by labeling my axis. So I can use that is 10 at 0, starting point, that is 10. This is 20. This is 30. And this is our x-axis. This other one we have, this is 10. This is 20. This is 30. This is 40. This is 50. And this is our y-axis. I have labeled like that because you can see the maximum value of y here is 50, and the maximum value of x we have is 20. So our graph will be able to cater for that. So with that, we go ahead and plot the graphs. Start with the x plus y less than 30. So when x is 10, y is 20. So that's our point there. When x is 20, y is 10, x like that. And because our symbol here is less than, we are going to draw a dotted line or incomplete line because that is not inclusive. So that is the line y, this is a graph of x plus y is equals to 30. We need to make it dotted. It should be look like that. And then we check the side that needs to be shaded off. So we check with 0, 0. So when x is 0 and y is 0, 0 is less than 30, that's correct. We take another point like 20, 20. So 20 plus 20 is 40. It is not less than 0, meaning that this is the side that we need to shade off. So that is the side that we don't need. The other line is 4x plus y. So we need to get this point. When x is 0, y is 50. When x is 10, y is 10. So that is a point. We join the two points to come up with a graph. So this is a graph of 4x plus y is equals to 50. Then we check the side that satisfies our inequality. Let's take 0, 0. So when x is 0, this is 4 times 0 is 0 plus y is 0, 0. 0 is not greater than 50. So that is the side that we don't need. So we shade off that region so that we are left with the other part. So we have shaded off that. The other one is, it is a complete line because 50 of our symbol here, it is greater than or equals to. So 50 is part of the inequality. The other one is y is equal to 2x. So when x is 0, y is 0, so we get that point. And when x is 20, y is 40. When x is 20, y is 40. We join the two points to come up with a graph. That's the graph of y is equals to, as a graph of y is equals to 2x. It is dotted because of our symbol here. It is greater than. So 2x is not part of the inequality. So we get this, we look for the side that satisfies our inequality. Let's take 10 and 0. So if we say x is 10 and y is 0, 0 is greater than 20. That's not correct. So just not to take a lot of time, that is a side that we need to shade off. That is a side that we don't need. So we have our small region here that is represented by this inequality. Now after that, we are going to get the objective function. Then from there we plot the search line. This is the region that we have obtained, and our region is quite small. So what I'm going to do is to magnify the region so that we can be able to see the various options that we have. I have magnified my graph so that we are able to identify the points. And one of the points is this one. This is a point of that is 7 and 22. So that is one option. So he can take 7 lorries and 2 pickups. Then the other point, since this line is complete, we can get that is a point, which is, we can say this is 8, x is 8, and y is 18. So that's another option. The other one is this point here, which is this point, and that point is 8 and 19. So this here it is 8 and here it is 19. So that's another option. The other one is this one, and that is at 8, 20, 8, 20, this is 8, the x is 8, and y is 20. The other one is this other point here, 8 and 21. The other one is we have this is that is 9, the x is 9, and the other one is 19, so that's another point. The other one is we have this point 9, and the other one is 20. So those are the options the farmer could take to transport the 1,000 bags. From here, let us calculate and see which option will give us the minimum expenditure. So we have identified the various options. Let's calculate and see the expenditure. So if we take the first option, we have 7. You multiply by 2,000, that is for the lorry, then you plus, there will be 20 times 900, and that should give you, using your calculator, you get it is at 3,800. So that will be the cost for that option. For the other option, we have 8 and 18. So we have 8 multiplied by 2,000, into bracket, and plus 18 pickup, so 18 times 900, and that should give us that is giving us 32,200. Then we pick this other option where we have 8 times 2,000. That is for the lorry. Then you add 19 times 900, and that is giving you that 3,100. Then you pick the other option where we have 8 and 20. So we have 8 multiplied by 2,000 close the bracket plus. That is, we have 20 multiplied by 900. This is giving us 34,000. Then we move to the other option. This is when we have 8 multiplied by 2,000 plus 21 times 900. And that is giving us 34,900. Then we have the other option, that is for 9. So we have here we have brackets, and here we have 9 multiplied by 2,000. Then you add to 19 multiplied by 900. And this is giving us 35,100. Then finally we have this one where we have 9 times 2,000. Then you add to the other is 20 plus 20 multiplied by 900. This is for the pickup, and that is giving us 36,000. So these are the various options the farmer could take. From the calculation, you can see that the lowest value, the expenditure, is where we have 32,200. So that is the lowest that is the lowest amount he can use to transport. We have done this so that when we come to determine optimization using Arura and set square, we can confirm that what you obtain using the instrument is the same, so that when you are given a question like this one, you only need to use Arura and set square to determine the maximum or the minimum. So now let's go ahead and use a ruler and a set square to see whether we'll be able to obtain this value. For us to use a ruler and a compass, we need to do a few things. Now, we are told that the cost of transporting using a lorry is 2000. So you put 2000x, the pickup is 900y. So this is called objective function. That objective function, what we do is we choose a point xy near or close to the region of possibility. In this case, let's choose the point 5 and 10. So this is 5 and 10, that point there. So we choose 5 and 10. We substitute in our objective function. So we say it is 2000 multiplied by 5 plus 900 times 10. That will give you 19,000. That is, this is 10,000 plus 9,000, you get 19,000. Using this figure and the objective function, then we form this equation, 2000x plus 900y is equals to 19,000. We can simplify this by dividing by 100, 100 and 100. So you end up with a function, 20x plus 9y is equals to 190. With this is called the search line. It is called the search line. We are going to plot this line. So we what we do here is we get 2 points. So we get x and y, and we see that when x is 5, you substitute here, this will be 100, take it to the other side, you'll be left with 90. 90 divided by 9 will be 10. We have y is 0, x is 9.5. So they are going to use this point to draw our search line. So when x is 5, y is 10, so we have that point. When y is 0, x is 9.5, so that's a point. We use those 2 points to draw that graph. So that is our search line, and it is a dotted line. So what we are going to do is, using the search line, we are going to place our ruler here and our set square, and we slide the set square. And the first edge, the first point that the edge of the set square lands on our region, that is the point where we get the minimum expenditure. So let's go ahead and do that. This is how you do your setup. So place the ruler, this is my ruler, along the search line. So one of the edges of the ruler to be along the search line. Place your set square, this is my set square, and holding the ruler down tightly, slide the set square so that in our region, the first point that will be touched by this edge will be the point giving us the minimum expenditure. So let's try and do that. So you move the set square upwards as you hold down the ruler, so that it does not move. So you realize that the first point where the set square touches the region, the first point, as we had seen, is the point 8 and that is 8 and 18, which was giving us 32. Let me magnify it so that you can see it clear. You can see, as we slide our set square upwards, the first point the edge of the set square touches is where we have this is 8. You can see here x is 8 and y is 18, so it is 8 and 18, which we had found earlier that it is the option that is giving us the lowest expenditure. That is when the farmer will take 8 lorries, will take 8 lorries and 18 pickups. So that is where you make the minimum expenditure. So that is how you go about it. That is how you use the set square to get the minimum and the maximum. For the maximum, it means that it will be the last point, the edge of the set square will touch as it exits the region. So that brings us to the end of this lesson. We are going to add other examples as we move on, but at least I have tried to explain how you go about it. You can go through an example and see whether you will be able to get the minimum or the maximum. So I'll be doing another example as we move on.